students, today we will see, in this video, we'll see the impact of globalization on human resources. See, so far we saw about the nature and environment. Isn't it time to see how it affects human beings? Yes? Okay, the first thing is about the farmers. We know, like for example, if you take in India, there are 70% in the rural area, okay? And there are many farmers. Agriculture is a very important part of our Indian society. And all these farmers, if you see, they have to get pesticides, they have to get fertilizers, they have to get seeds, okay? For all this, they depend on loans. Actually, they take loans and they start a crop. And if it is going to give a bumper harvest, fine, okay? But many a time there aren't enough rains or something or the other happens and there is some fungus or pests that are coming and eating it up, then what happens? It results in crop failure. What happens to the loan? They are in debt, okay? So that results in debt. Now then we have a disparate society. Disparate means something that cannot be patched up. Okay, there's so much of difference between two people. Okay, one is the mind workers. You've seen people sitting in front of the system, the computer or the laptop, and all the time working, 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 and their mind is all the time working. Even when they are sleeping, in the subconscious mind, something or the other is working. They are called as mind workers, and they earn a lot of money. And you have the skilled laborers, like you see the construction people, people who help in the construction of things, people who assemble things, people who set right the vehicles. All these people are called skilled laborers. If you see there, there is a lot of disparity and there is a lot of income inequity in between these two. There is no patching up at all. That is, again, that is one of the impact on the human resources. Then you have these industries. See, when big units are set up, with so many machines and so many people are employed there, what happens to the small scale industries? They are all just smashed. Okay, so that is why Gandhiji brought up something to bring about the upliftment of the small scale or the cottage industries. Okay, so here the big industries will flourish. It is like, you know, the rich get richer and the poor get poorer. You know, that is how it is. And the small scale industries are affected. Okay, all right. Then we also have the, when you come to the most important thing, it is the debt trap. Sometimes what happens is, now let us take the example of the farmer. He has taken a loan and he's in debt. Debt means he has to give that money to the bank or anything, or otherwise the land will not come back to his name. Now there is somebody else, a big landowner, who says, I would give that money and clear your loan. So what's happening? He is indebted to a greater debt. He's trapped in that debt. Thereby one debt is freed from that debt, but he's into a greater one. That's what this picture shows. Okay, so the debt is a big trap on your shoulder that you are not able to come out of it. That is called as a debt trap. And this is one of the very important thing on the human resource, especially people having small scale industries and farmers, they face this debt trap a lot. Even these small scale industries, when they're just flourishing, they need loans. And suddenly if something happens, what happens? That loan, they are not able to repay. Even you can take a small vehicle that you have taken on loan, and if you're not able to repay, the vehicle is seized. So to prevent that, somebody comes with a higher rate of interest, they come and give you money. Now what is that called? It's a debt trap. Okay, so that's another thing. Then recession. Recession, everybody knows, it's a downfall in economy. Okay, the economy goes down, there is a downfall. Next is national debt. Sometimes, supposing you have natural calamities like tsunami, floods and storms, and you know, you have not expected such things at all, then what happens is, during such natural calamities, there's a huge loss which cannot be met out by the government. Then the government goes and approaches places like International Monetary Fund, okay, or World Bank to give them some loan. That is called as national debt. The last one, but the most interesting one, is the brain drain. Okay, as the picture shows, these people are having some wings on their heads. Yes, do you see that? Yeah, you are right. What happens is, from the poor countries, just we know about the globalization, they have an idea. Okay, this country gives me this much of income. I have that skill. I have the capacity. Why not try in that country so that I can clear up all my debts? I can clear up the debts of my parents or my forefathers. So this is how they try and plan. So they study well, they equip themselves, and they try to go. So what happens? These are skilled, okay, highly skilled, highly educated. Or they go there and they equip themselves, they educate themselves, and then they get a very good job. So this migration of skilled workers from poor countries to rich countries happen at a large pace. Okay, at a large pace it is happening. And when this happens, what does it got to do with brain drain? So this brain behind, the skilled workers, okay, they will be so knowledgeable, their wisdom and knowledge will be so much, but that wisdom and knowledge which is supposed to be used here, it is just moving out to another country. So it is drained out. That is called as brain drain, okay? But now my challenge to you is, can we bring back, after you finish, after you fulfill your mission, if you could come back, then it is like that brain drain, we can come back to brain gain. Let that be a challenge for us, okay? Let it not be a brain drain. Let us all get all the benefits and then run away from this place. No. Let us give that same benefit back to our place. Okay, so that is brain gain. All right. Okay, so once again, impact on human resources. The first one is agriculture. Very badly affected are the farmers. Okay, because of the loan, they sometimes are in constant debt. And you must be hearing very often that they end their lives because they're not able to meet out the debts. They're not able to clear the debts at all. Sometimes because of that, for generations, there is slavery. They are bonded slaves for some landlords. So they have to serve them, and their land also goes to the landlords if they are not able to clear the debt. Then comes the industries. Industries are good, very inviting, very nice, but at the same time, they don't support or they don't allow the small scale or cottage industries to flourish. The next one is disparate society. I think in this world, we must come into the equality. Okay, we cannot have the rich getting richer and the poor getting poorer. Okay, then the next one is debt trap. Let not anybody allure you into another bigger trap. Okay, whatever you can, you do it within your capacity. That is what is debt trap. Next is recession, national debt, and then the brain drain. So these are the impacts on human resources. If you have liked this video, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to this channel. Bye-bye.